we go for the next topic, arthritis, a basic view on synovial fluid and articular cartilage. Synovial fluid is secreted by the synovial membrane surrounding the joints. Everywhere, whether it is lungs or whether it is liver or wherever, there are two types of cells. One are phagocytic and one does the native function of that particular organ. So in lungs, they secrete surfactant, and liver, they do something else. So phagocytic type A cells here are phagocytic macrophages. Type B are those which secrete the hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid is a very, very important constituent of the synovial fluid, and it is this constituent which gives lubrication to the joint. Every joint has a lubricant. Even in our routine, what we see, machines and, you know, vehicles, etc., wherever there are joints, you have to have some lubrication there. Okay, so even our joints has a natural lubrication in the form of synovial fluid, and in that synovial fluid is the hyaluronic acid, which is very important. Therefore, in osteoarthritis, in old age, when the synovial fluid has, the quantity has come down, etc., there is artificial hyaluronic acid prepared in the lab, and we give in injections of hyaluronic acid. That's called as viscosupplementation. The process of injecting artificial hyaluronic acid into the joint is called as viscosupplementation. I give good number of injections into my old patients who come. It's a pre-filled syringe, hyaluronic acid 5 ml, almost 10,000 rupees is the cost. 10,000 rupees is the cost of manufacturing hyaluronic acid into a laboratory. Our body is producing so many ml every day, but we can't take it out and do that business. Maybe I don't know in future. So it follows non-Newtonian fluid mechanics. Yes, there is a possibility. No, these days we are even renting womb. I mean, I don't endorse that phenomenon anyways, and even the government has banned, we are renting womb. No, so what is there? Synovium, you do something, aspirate the hyaluronic acid and inject into somebody else. 10,000 rupees is the cost here, 1,000 also is okay. Person will donate. So there is something called as chemistry, where, you know, fluids behave in some way. I mean, I don't know all the details of how the fluid behaves, water behaves, etc. But this synovial fluid behaves as non-Newtonian fluid mechanics. Remember it. It has got a variable viscosity. The viscosity differs at different times. This is about synovial fluid. Coming to articular cartilage. Articular cartilage is that cartilage which is present at the end of the bones. It's like a cap. If it's like a long bone, at the end of the bone, this end, there is something like a cap. It is because of this cap I am able to stand, you are able to sit, you are able to walk. If this cap is not there, we will not be able to, because these bones and bones will touch together. Now, when the bones are touching, it is actually the caps which are touching, not the bone proper. Now, because these caps are touching, you don't have pain. Why? Because poor nose. No, it has no vessels, it has no nerve supply, it has no perichondrium, it does not regenerate. All nose. Because of this nose, we are yes. Because in the sense, we are able to do something. It is formed of hyaline cartilage. Articular cartilage, that means articular joint cartilage, that cartilage which is at the end of the bone is made up of hyaline cartilage. It has none of these four things. Now, because it has no ability to regenerate, we are unable to treat osteoarthritis properly. Now, what is osteoarthritis? Age related wear and tear. What is that wear and tear? Wear and tear of the articular cartilage. The cap is very good in young age, but as the age progresses, the cap is lost. Sometimes patchy, sometimes a big, like how the paint comes out from the wall, sometimes it comes out little bit, sometimes the entire goes away. Once articular cartilage is lost, the bone inside has got all this supply now. It has blood vessels, it has nerve supply, everything. Because it has nerve supply, if it touches two bones together, you'll have a lot of pain. If suppose it has ability to regenerate, we would have regenerated it. Because it has no ability to regenerate, what to do? Replace. You cannot regenerate, you replace it. So therefore, you have replacement, knee replacement and hip replacement. And most of the hospitals are running by this ability, inability of the articular cartilage not to regenerate. Because knee replacement is 2 lakhs and hip replacement is 2.5 lakhs. If this God had given the ability of articular to regenerate, then you can understand. Our financial mechanics would have changed. Histological zones of articular cartilage. There are 4 zones. Middle one, radial, where the chondrocytes are most active. Okay, superficial is that which is closer to the joint. Calcified cartilage is that which is closer to the bone. So third, radial, also called as medial or deep. here the chondrocytes are most active. Aging changes, articular cartilage goes into certain aging changes where there is increase in the water content and loss of proteoglycans, degradation of proteoglycans, disruption of the collagen network. Okay, so water content increases, at least this you should remember. You know, ఏం లేదు ఇంకా అన్ని నీళ్ళే ఉంది అని అంటారు కదా. ఇన్ యూ గ్రో ఓల్డ్ వాట్ ఈస్ దర్ దిస్ నో మసల్ మాస్, ఇట్స్ ఆల్ వాటర్. ఎనీవేస్ బాడీ ఈజ్ వాటర్ ఓన్లీ, బట్ యాజ్ యూ గ్రో ఓల్డ్ ద మసల్ మాస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో డిక్రీజింగ్. పీపుల్ బికమ్ థిన్నర్ సమ్ టైమ్స్, నథింగ్ ఈజ్ లెఫ్ట్, వాట్ ఈస్ లెఫ్ట్ ఈజ్ ఓన్లీ వాటర్. సో వాటర్ ఈజ్ ఇంక్రీస్ యాజ్ ద ఏజ్ గ్రోస్ ఎవ్రీవేర్, ఇట్ ఈస్ వాటర్ విత్ ఇంక్రీజెస్. సో ఎట్లీస్ట్ రిమెంబర్ వాటర్ ఇంక్రీజ్. యూ డోంట్ రిమెంబర్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ లైక్ నో ప్రాబ్లమ్, దెర్ విల్ బి సమ్ ఆప్షన్ విచ్ విల్ హెల్ప్ యూ టు పిక్ ది కరెక్ట్ ఆన్సర్. సో రిమెంబర్ వాటర్ ఇంక్రీజెస్ ఎవ్రీవేర్ ఇన్ ద బాడీ యాజ్ ద బాడీ ఏజెస్. Now this table is important. C12, what are the joints involved in the different types of arthritis? Rheumatic, psoriatic, it is abbreviated rheumatic, osteo, psoriatic, angspon. What are the different joints and these joints are involved by what arthritis? Now it might be very confusing for you to see this, very confusing, and how is this I am unable to remember. Remember five things. More than involvement, remember what is not involved, then you will be able to answer it. DIP, not involved by rheumatoid arthritis. You cannot forget this. DIP, distal interphalangeal joint, not involved by rheumatoid arthritis. Metacarpophalangeal joints and wrist, not involved by osteoarthritis. It's two things. DIP not involved by rheumatoid, MCP and wrist not involved by osteoarthritis. Then involvement of two things you remember. Base of the thumb, what is this? Carpo-metacarpal joint. Carpals, carpo, first carpo-metacarpal joint is base of the thumb, characteristically involved in osteoarthritis. And then axial skeleton, A goes with A, ankylosing spondylitis. Axial skeleton spine is not involved in most of the other things, but axial skeleton is involved in ankylosing spondylitis. Two sparing, two involving. Two sparing is DIP spared by RA. MCP and wrist are spared by osteo. Two involvement, base of the thumb, first carpo metacarpal, base of the thumb, osteo, axial skeleton, ankylosing spondylitis. Now with this you will be able to answer 99% of the questions related to this table. Now if you try to remember this table, it may become very difficult. You may ultimately remember nothing. So it is better to remember these four things: two sparing, two involving. Okay, in specifically joint osteoarthritis, again there are specific predilections. What, which joint is commonly involved in osteoarthritis, which joints? I have already told you, first carpo metacarpal is characteristically involved in osteoarthritis, that's been mentioned in hand. Again, I am trying to simplify this table. In hand, first carpo metacarpal joint most commonly involved. Osteoarthritis, MCP and wrist is spared. See the last one, spared, wrist, MCP. Also elbow and ankle, but even if you don't remember that, wrist and MCP are spared. In hand, involved are first carpo, involved are DIP, PIP, first CMC. All these are involved, but don't forget CMC. Okay? Uncommonly it is shoulder. Shoulder also uncommon. All these things are involved. Osteoarthritis can involve any joint for that matter. Fine. Look at this picture there. Wherever joint is involved, it becomes swollen up and becomes little firm. Then it will take the shape of a node. If it is DIP, it is called as Heberden's node. If it is PIP, it is called as a Bouchard's node. Questions are asked on this. DIP, Heberden, PAP, Bouchard nodes. Thickening of the joint forms like a nodule. Osteoarthritis is age related wear and tear arthritis. The next group of arthritis is inflammatory arthritis. Though osteoarthritis has got ITIS in the name, but it is not purely inflammatory. As you all know, anything inflammatory ends with ITIS, appendicitis or anything. IS in the last is inflammation. Osteoarthritis, though it has got inflammation, but it's a different kind of inflammation where immune system is not involved. But in inflammatory arthritis are those group of disorders involving the joint, causing destruction of the joint, involving the immune system, antigen antibody reactions and collagen complement system. So involving the immune system, those disorders which involve the joints come under the broad category of inflammatory arthritis. Now this is divided as follows: seropositive and seronegative spondyloarthropathies, you call it. Seropositive is only one, that is rheumatoid arthritis. Seropositive or rheumatoid arthritis factor, RA factor, is positive. It can be negative also, but it can be positive also. Seropositive is RA. Seronegative is 4. Angspond, reactive arthritis, also called as Reiter's syndrome, psoriatic arthritis, enteropathic arthritis, or UBD associated arthritis, that is inflammatory bowel disease associated arthritis, is enteropathic arthritis. These four are seronegative. Why they are called as seronegative? Because RA factor is absent in them. Rest of the features are all similar, but RA factor is absent, therefore they are seronegative. Crystal associated arthropathy, gout and pseudo gout. Characteristic presence of crystals in the joint. If it is involving knee joint, aspirate the synovial fluid, see under microscope, you will find characteristic crystals. So therefore it is called as crystal associated arthropathy, gout and pseudo gout. All these inflammatory arthritis which I have told you, seropositive, seronegative, crystal associated, all are inflammatory, all are erosive. They cause erosions. Non-erosive are OA and SLE. OA anyways is not come under this category of inflammation. But remember this, OA and SLE, these two are non-erosive. Rest all are erosive arthritis, they cause erosion. Seropositive, seronegative and crystal associated arthritis. Few points about different arthritis is neuropathic arthritis, also called as Charcot joint. Heard in before? Neuropathic arthritis, Charcot joint. Heard before? You might have heard in tibialis dorsalis in medicine. It is a progressive dystrophic arthritis. Pathological important thing is there is loss of pain and proprioception. The patient is unable to feel the pain and unable to sense the pressure and surrounding things, proprioception. Why this happens? When there is damage to the nervous system. How is it possible? All those conditions which probably damage the nerves, causes peripheral neuropathy, will result in this, should result in this. Therefore, diabetes becomes the most commonest cause in India. Diabetes causes three things. What are the three things? Neuropathy, angiopathy, there's something else. Ask Murali sir, he may tell you. So, neuropathy, diabetic neuropathy, loss of pain sensation. Then when the patient is walking and when the patient is moving around, there is a constant repetitive trauma, especially to the lower limbs. And the patient is unable to feel it. If I am walking on something hot or something very thorny, because of the pain sensation, immediately I will realize and I will go away from it. But here in this case, they don't have pain sensation. Therefore, their foot and ankle are subjected to repetitive trauma and becomes very, very bad. Fractures, dislocations, subluxations, all possible worst situations can occur in their joints, but they don't realize it. Okay. But then if they are then not realizing, then doctor, why are they coming to the hospital in the first place? If they don't realize, why do they come to the hospital? Because they are unable to walk. For walking, structure has to be intact. They might not be feeling pain, but they are unable to walk. There is subluxation, instability. So because of that instability, they come to you. Recently, there was a case of a diabetic lady around 35-40 year old. So she came with the same complaint of instability, unable to walk. I took the x-rays, ankle and foot. I have the x-ray, but not this one, the other x-ray. Very, very, very bad joints. If you look at the x-ray, you will feel that it is a severe trauma, some road traffic accident, severe road traffic accident, crushing injury. That kind of picture you will see there in the x-ray. But there is no trauma as such there, and the patient is able to walk. So therefore, you will find all these things. Fragmentation, hibernation, osteophytes, erosions, fractures, loose bodies, effusions, all sorts of possible things, damaging things, you can find it in the x-ray of the neuropathic joint or a Charcot joint, ultimately leading to instability, subluxation and dislocation. Okay? Diabetes is the most common cause. Therefore, it is called as paradox. Why? Symptoms are much less than the x-ray appearance. Look at that x-ray. Don't you feel it is very bad? In fact, x-rays are worse than this. This is a better x-ray which I have showing you. X-rays are worse than this. Very, very bad x-ray. All that metatarsals will blow away like this. one this side, one that side, one this side. So that usually happens in a very severe injury. So, but the patient has, looking by the x-ray, you will feel the patient has a lot of symptoms, but the patient is not very symptomatic. That's the paradox in a neuropathic and a Charcot's joint. Diabetes, if it is the cause, mid-tarsal area is the most common involved. Tabes, if it is the cause, then it is the knee joint which is most common involved. Okay. Treatment is rest, support, braces and arthrodesis. Remember arthrodesis. Arthrodesis is fusing the joint. There is, you cannot do replacement here. Because for a replacement to function, pain and proprioception has to be there. If they are not there, then he will not realize whatever you do. The implants will also fail. Therefore, you cannot replace. So, what is the replacement? Whenever a joint is damaged, I have told you, it cannot regenerate, replace it. Here the joint is damaged, no? So, it cannot regenerate. Joint cannot regenerate there. So, replace it. But in neuropathic joint, don't replace. The replace is going to fail. The patient cannot realize. The implants will also fail. So, it is arthrodesis is better if you fuse the joint. Loose bodies, another topic, few points on loose bodies. Knee is the commonest joint where you find majority of the loose bodies. Another reason could be that the knee joint has got a lot of space when you compare to the other joints. Therefore, you find a lot of loose bodies there. Causes, osteoarthritis, most common cause for loose bodies. Single loose body is a fracture. How the patient suddenly going, with some hit, small fragment of the distal end of the femur is broken and dropped into the joint. He will not have any disability with it. Pain for a few days and start walking, and later for some reason you take an x-ray, you will find one single piece of bone. It's called an osteochondral fracture. Hundreds of loose bodies, small, 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 it can be chondromatosis, synovial chondromatosis. Okay. So, osteoarthritis is the most common cause of loose bodies. Knee is the commonest site. Okay. Read that question. 56 year old, diabetes, swelling in the ankle, effusion, minimal pain. Let us stop here. Diabetic patient, what is his complaint? His complaint is not pain, only minimal pain. He is not coming with pain, but he is coming with swelling and effusion, some other, but not pain. So, what it could be? Charcot joint, neuropathic joint, as Arshil told you, pain is very less. So, now what are the x-rays showing? Severe osteopenia, bone destruction, extensive loose bodies and extensive osteophytes. That means very bad joint, but still minimal pain. So, diagnosis is neuropathic joint or Charcot joint, and diabetes is the most common cause that for this person is a diabetic. So, how do you manage? You manage by all except don't do replacement. Okay. So, rest, splinting, aspiration, compression, bandage, arthrodesis is best, but no replacement. All of the following statements about synovial fluid are true except. There are two types of cells in the synovial membrane. What are they? Type A and B. What does the type A do? Phagocyte. Type B secretes something I told you. Business. Hyaluronic acid. So, type B secretes hyaluronic acid, but here he says type A. That should be false. What about B? Follows non-Newtonian fluid kinetics. True. Contains hyaluronic acid is also true. Viscosity variable is also true. So, the answer is type A are macrophages. They do not secrete anything. Which of the following statements about articular cartilage with aging? I told you to remember only one thing in aging. Water, water. Everywhere there is water, not a drop to drink and chapter. So, what is the answer is, total water content cartilage is decreased, is wrong. Even if you don't know A, B, most if in next time also if they ask, they will use something related to water. Okay. So, total proteoglycan content is decreased is true. Synthesis of proteoglycan is decreased is also true. Degradation of the proteoglycans is increased. That could be another option. Degradation of proteoglycans is increased. Most active chondrocytes is in which layer? Third layer, zone 3. No discussions here. What is true about articular cartilage? Four nose. Articular cartilage true is no nerve supply. Very vascular, no. No perichondrium. And it is not a fibrocartilage. It is a hyaline cartilage. So it has no nerve supply. So now here, before we discuss the question, two things spared, two things involved. Spared, DIP spared in rheumatoid. And MCP and wrist are spared in osteo. Involvement characteristic, base of thumb, first carpal, metacarpal, osteo, and axial skeleton, Angstrom. Look at this joint not involved in osteoarthritis. MCP and wrist. MCP is one of the options. DAP is not involved in RA. Option B. If it is joint not involved in rheumatoid arthritis, is option becomes B. DAP. Why? I don't know. Why DAP is not involved? I don't know. Nowhere it is mentioned. It is not involved, remember it. That's it. No further questions. There are many things which we don't know. What we should know is this is the question which will be asked. Okay? Joint not involved in osteoarthritis is C. Now, which can cause loose body in the joint? Osteoarthritis. Otherwise, osteochondral fracture, if it is single, hundreds of loose bodies in chondromatosis. Most common site for loose body, joint which has got maximum space is knee. Loose bodies are common in the knee. And also remember that loose bodies will be common in the joints of the lower limb, because you are walking, they are put to lot of stress. Upper joints of the upper limb are not put to stress, so those chances are less. That's why knee osteoarthritis is very common, because these knees are so faithful to you for the last 60 years, and naturally they'll give some trouble to you after 60 years. You know, people cannot stay together in one room for few years. Knee. Two types of nodes in osteoarthritis, DIP and PIP. Pardon? DIP is Heberden's, PIP is Bouchard's node. So here, Heberden's, it has to be DIP. Am I right? Yes, I am right. Osteoarthritis, what is not seen? One thing you know, base of the thumb characteristically involved. So D is ruled out. First carpal metacarpal joint, it involves. Knee is the most common. You will find every day if you see on the road, recollect all who are walking, waddling gait, it is knee osteoarthritis. Another among ankle and hip, it is hip is the second most common joint which is involved. Hip osteoarthritis. Western countries, it is hip which is more common. In India, it is knee which is common. Another point, let me tell you. In Western countries, hip replacement is commonly done than knee replacement. In India, knee replacement is commonly done as hip replacement for various reasons. Okay. So ankle joints are least involved. It was there on the table, but I did not want to confuse you. Involving DIP, option B, rheumatoid arthritis is ruled out. Involving DIP. Sparing of MCP has to be osteo only. So the answer is osteoarthritis. Psoriatic arthritis, remember one thing, it can involve any joint, it can spare any joint. It's very good. Whatever joint you want, they will say okay. Whatever joint you don't want, they will say no, I want to squint, please spare me of knee. Okay, no problem. I'll involve something else. So that is psoriatic arthritis. They are less common. Usually don't find psoriatic arthritis so commonly in clinical practice. You find psoriasis as skin lesions, but psoriatic arthritis is not very common.